Hello, and welcome to episode 4 of season 2 of Archivist Creed. And last episode we basically did some preparatory work. We gathered lots of codex pages, we had a look at those. And now, we're going to head to Florence and go and find Federico in the Pazzi and hopefully assassinate him. Because that's what assassins do. They keep all their hidden knowledge about how the world really is to themselves and keep that super secret. And just occasionally go around assassinating people to protect humanity's freedom. Although, of course, in this case, we're not barely protecting humanity's freedom, more so we're getting revenge on the people who killed our father. Anyway, before we do all that, I just want to check out our new mine that we just paid for. Because I seem to remember that you could find stuff if you went down it. This is closed. Is that your mine? Check if the recording is running. Yes, it is. Well, hello. This is a fancy mine structure. This interesting, structure for a mine type area. Also, nobody seems to actually be mining anything, and the mine is right below my house, so maybe that's a good thing. Yep. Some money, that's disappointing. I mean, money's nice. Don't get me wrong. Just be nice if there is more than just money to be found here. Anyway, we can recoup the cost of our mine a bit this way. Oops! Ouch! Ah, new. Hello, horsey. Let's go to France. Hello, Walking Money.
Vile murderer, stay away!
Yay, money. What'd you get by kicking someone? So there's a lesson for you boys and girls. Maybe. Anyway, no, not going to tell you yet. I want to save up money for the big improvements to my house. What I do want is a doctor.
Is there something ill, you friend?
Nice. I'm sure I want that. Health, please.
Trust me, you'll soon feel much better.
Off to find the fox. I'm not exactly sure how much florins were worth in this time period. I
kill all trespassers, Pazzo. What are you doing here?
Strongly suspect.
You're not allowed up here.
The value assigned to in this game is purely for gameplay purposes and this
you are finished.
Little relationship to the actual value, based on what I've seen of other games, specifically Syndicate, where I do have a rough idea of the value of money in that time period. But that doctor was a bit of a waste, wasn't it? Got the Vecchio, the old markets. And the glyph, yay! Castle established first in Roman times a site of Mark Forum. Only in 1030 was first documented as a marketplace. The forum was also a marketplace usually. That's why it became the forum, because the market was where all the life of the city happened, and therefore also the political life. Anyway, we're finding time. Sparkle there. Excellent. Hello, Glyph.
Something was up there. Something abandoned long ago.
So. Find the eagle. Okay. This part of the game, narratively. Makes. Little sense to me because. This is supposedly subject 16, right? He's discovered some stuff and he wants people to. Now what he's discovered, it hides it behind all these strange encodings. The thing is, the Templars know all this already, right? Because he got this from the Templar files. So there's no point hiding it to them. For them, right? Rarely know it. And the rest of humanity presumably wants to know this, because this is the truth. So, while this masquerade, besides if it's easy enough for us to find, you know, some of these puzzles right on the Templars. Puzzles. So this one we can move separately, okay, so don't have to worry about position in a ring. So we can move this one, okay, so that's in position last. And these are all together. That one, it's okay, that one I can move. These have to move together. Well, and these you have to move together. They always stick together, right? Okay. This one I can put it to you, then you can put you together. You together. No? What am I missing here? Surely this fits. You should tell me the whole thing should be turned. Right, just much immersion as well. Templar symbols. Now, Session symbols. So the Session supported the moon landing. The Templars were already there. That's what they're implying. It's an interesting spin on the moon landing hoax. Hello. If you did conspiracy theory, right? So conspiracy theory is we didn't go to the moon, it was all faked by NASA or American government, whatever. And here the spin is we did go to the moon, but because of conspiracies.
With Jack deep underground, it was easy.
So, coming out of the way. Let's go find the fox. He's apparently not just a thief, but also some kind of ganglord, because you don't want to say the person's name out loud. Even when you're inside your own home, where you happily keep dead guards. No, no, no! Trust it.
A big mistake, my friend. Enough of this.
Enough indeed. Why don't you give up?
Return what you've stolen.
Would if I could, but I can't.
I really have no interest.
Now we're on roof. Okay.
So give me back my money, and we'll call it even.
Not so fast. What do you want? Who are you? They call me many things. Murderer, tagliagole, thief. But you may call me La Volpe. At your service, Messer Ezio. Do you know my name? It is my business to know everything in this city. Isn't that why you're here?
Indeed. I need to find someone. To know where he'll be before even he does.
Who?
Francesco de Pazzi.
There's word on the street of a caravan just arrived from Roma. A secret meeting at sunset tonight. You can learn something of Francesco's whereabouts there.
Do you know where it is to be held?
Ma certo. Let me know when you are ready, and we'll go. Ah, yes. Here is your money.
Hooray, money, no, it's just...
I must be working, Gerard.
Must move fast. Think you can keep up?
That's your problema.
Ha ha ha!
What are you doing back there? I said to keep up with me.
Well, Kay would give him control.
Francesco Di Pazzi is meeting his people inside that church.
How do I join them?
There are catacombs that run under the city. They will lead you to a place where you can eavesdrop on the meeting. Grip that stone handle, turn it, then slide it down.
Thank you for all your help, Volpe.
Buona fortuna.
And he gave us some money too. That's for the man. Whoops! Drats. Really doubt you could make a mechanism like that without electricity. Fancy catacombs. Bullet catacombs.
How long do we have to stand here, Saverio?
It's so cold. What do you want, Ilario? Messer Pazzi is paying us good money to watch the entrance, and the dead won't try to murder us. I can't wait to go home to Elena and tell her how much gold we made tonight.
Pretty massive structure to be underground. I mean, the game's kind of implying that this is historical, these catacombs, right? I mean, it'd be one thing if it was, you know, some kind of secret, mystical, ancient beings built building. For now, the game has been implying that this is historical. and things kind of what I have with Assassin's Creed on the whole. Part of the draw for me is to kind of be able to some way, some small way, experience these historical time periods and learn a bit of cool history that they didn't know about before. I would hope that if they were to hang on a sec. What would help with that is if they were to somewhere, somehow indicate, you know, what was real, what was made up. And I realize they don't do it in the game, and certainly not the one in the game 100% historically accurate. But, you know, they're making a game, not a documentary. But just, no, okay. If you could. Somewhere find out what's real, what's not, then that would be cool. Why the heck? Secretary, look at this. Nice. Why the heck are they lifting out these coffins? Makes this look also effortless, but let me tell you, in real life you don't want to do that, and also you have to be pretty fit to do this kind of thing. So hurrah, I can swim, unlike my ancestor. Away.
Merda! The door! Keep watch while I go look. This was supposed to be an easy job.
I told you we shouldn't have come here. If I hear anything, I'm running to the other guard post, so help me God!
Can't use throwing knives here? Come on, game.
Not you! Where do you think you're going? Eccolo! There! There!
watch a movie, if I do say so myself.
Saverio! I'll be back with the other guards!
Have to find a way out before it kills me.
That is one super athletic guard.
Leave me alone!
Yes. Yes. I think I got away.
Think. So what are we missing here?
Yes, I think I got away.
Go that way. There you are. Thank you for hanging around. One of the scripted chase scenes. Don't get me wrong, I'd hate to have to replay this 5 times. Shush, man.
I'm being chased! Get him!
Only a good use throwing knives. These are some seriously impressive catacombs. Oh well. Hello, guys.
Where have I seen him before?
Remember what I told you, ragazzi.
You retire quickly, so no risky strikes. Wait for a good opening.
Get to the door. Sure. Interesting touch. You can loot people, but worth it for the time it takes. And the amount of money I get.
patris et filii et spiritus sancti descendat super vos et maneat semper.
Grazie, padre. Bernardo?
It's all here. Swords, staves, axes, armor, bows. Our men will want for nothing.
I take this gift to mean the Pope consents.
He gave his blessing to the operation. As long as nobody's killed.
We're all set for the Duomo in the morning, Signore. The bait's been laid, but it wasn't easy. His fool brother keeps changing his plans.
Si. We'll need to be on hand to make sure Giuliano even gets out of bed for church tomorrow.
What is it, Jacopo? Do you think they suspect something?
Impossible! The Medici are too arrogant or too stupid to even notice. Likely a bit of both.
Do not underestimate our enemies, Francesco. Or have you already forgotten how your son was murdered?
We'll suffer no such surprises this time, Maestro. You have my word.
Molto bene. I should be off. I've some other business to attend to before I return to Rome. Gentlemen, tomorrow a new sun rises over Firenze. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
So, interesting that they first have a Catholic prayer in Latin, and then they talk about the Father of Understanding, unless they see the Father of Understanding as God the Father from the Catholic reef.
It's identical to one in the Villa Auditore. I think you've stumbled onto one of the assassin's tombs Ezio's uncle mentioned.
Well, ain't that nice.
Now that we know the way in, I'll tag the landmarks containing tombs in the database.
Orthodox cross. Tomb, supposedly for Persian assassin who died, well, Xerxes was 2,000 years before time's game set. Roman looking emperor head. Same symbol that is on the catacombs. Interesting. Apparently assassins want to be mummified. What do you know? You have a seal. Very good. Ooh, and monies. Look at all the monies.
Francesco will be and when. But
what is it?
I overheard something. They have weapons, enough for a battalion. Even the Pope has given support.
Typical of Sixtus. But what the hell are they planning?
I couldn't understand the specifics, but it involves the Medici, and it begins tomorrow morning at the Duomo.
The Medici will all be there for Sunday service. Along with the rest of Firenze. They're going to do it right in the middle of High Mass.
But it's also a chance for me to blend with the crowd, get close, and stop this madness.
If they succeed, if we lose Lorenzo and Firenze falls to the pazzi...
It will not come to that. I promise.
I hope you are right.
I'm not quite sure what then, because... they'd basically be... swapping one dictator for another. I mean, the Medici's took the Republic and basically turned it into a hereditary monarchy in all but name. So, you know, if we're helping Lorenzo because it's good for the Assassin's political position, etc., it's fine by me, but don't make this into some kind of grand striking for freedom democracy type thing, because it's just power politics. Of course, the Pazzi coup, it did really happen. And as I've already mentioned, today is not going to be a good day for Lorenzo's brother. Probably. Should never know how far they've stuck to real life. Guess we're about to find out. But before that, the knight is still young. Do you have time to visit the other secret tomb in the city? That's what I intended. Sorry. Ah, there's secret entrance. No guys, don't mind me. I'm just going to use this mechanism that apparently no one has ever noticed on this landmark.
Stay away from the artwork on the walls. And when your men paint the dome, take care not to disturb any of the sacred relics in the lanterna on top. They are the most important artifacts in our church.
Yes, yes, Padre. Just make sure to pay us the full sum for our work.
Pretty cool, we get to go inside. Beautiful marble floors. Not much painting yet. So it all came slightly later. And especially in the... thanks to the Reformation, actually. Because the Reformation inspired a lot of bad stuff. Such as all the Inquisition and burning of heretics and stuff. Well, Inquisition was somewhat earlier, but Reformation certainly gave it a boost. But the Reformation also brought the Counter-Reformation, where the Catholic Church decided that one way they could compete, so to speak, with Protestants churches.
Ben, now I have a way back up in case I fall.
Yeah, Catholic Church decided that how they could compete with Protestant churches was by making their churches visually more inspired, so to speak, so to more beautiful, and sponsored a lot of great art, kind of bring the glory of God or the Catholic conception of God to people's vision clearly. I hope that people would find that more appealing way of experiencing God than Protestant faith, which had sworn off a lot of doing artwork in churches and very plain churches. At least in Holland, there was the Beeldenstorm. So the statue or image storm, where a lot of artwork was smashed in Catholic churches. So it was considered to be against one of the commandments and the more general prohibition against idolatry. Where am I? Here am I. Oops. I suspect I might be missing something there. I could go to that. But Chinese. Same image in each window. It's responding. Checkpoint reached. Yeah, but you're restarted if you fall or if you die. So if the latter, I hope the fall kills me. Yeah, I'm not entirely convinced this was the way I normally got here. Hello. This old lady. Hey, lots of monies. Can you relieve you? Stage leap of faith. And we're right in time to stop Leonardo de Medici getting assassinated. Ain't that grand?
Francesco. There he is. Just right.
Giuliano! No!
Nessuno attaccato! Calma, l'ho detto! Fuori! Fuori! Fuori!
Your day is done, Lorenzo! Your entire family dies by my sword! Fuck!
You brought this on yourself! Die! And die already!
Wait, please! I need help!
Lorenzo di Medici. Ready? Okay, we don't get to kill Lorenzo, fine. Oops. Actually, I want to try out a knife. Ha! Can't kill him. Fine. Whoops!
saved my life.
It's nothing. But the man who did this to you has to pay.
Not now. I need help first. To my home. People I trust there. Can you...
Sure.
Right, this way. I'm losing a lot of blood.
Hang on, signore. I'm moving as fast as I can.
Burning barricades.
I'm just going to bat this! I'll kill you and out of here! I'll wipe the entire family from the city! They'll be erased!
Quietate, signore. Conserve your energy, or I'll be delivering a corpse. We're almost there now.
I've not forgotten how to wage war. I'm more than capable of
falling.
Oh, that's a nice backstab.
I'm with you.
I'm more than capable of cutting you down. I'm more than capable of cutting you down.
No, no. Why am I becoming notorious for protecting the ruler of the city? Oops. Well known, I suppose. Makes sense. So you're losing lots of blood, but you can do this, right? Marines' guards actually came to help us. Oops.
You belong down below with the rabble.
Get down, or I'll
Mamma mia!
You belong down below with the rabble.
Now!
Ha! I'm more than capable of... I had hoped combat could be avoided. Ha! I'm more than capable of that. I've not forgotten how to wage war. I had hoped the odds could be avoided. So be it.
Segun.
Lorenzo has been wounded! Aprite la porta!
What's the password?
Poliziano, open the maledetta porta!
By the Christ gracious, come in, quickly! The city is at war! Hurry!
Wait. I am in your debt. Tell me, why did you help me?
You are not the only one who lost a brother to the pazzi. My name is Ezio Auditore.
Ah. You're Giovanni's son. Your father was a good man. He understood honor, loyalty.
The Pazzi thugs are storming the Palazzo della Signoria. We cannot hold them off much longer.
No. If they get inside, they'll murder our supporters and put their own devils in power.
Then my survival would mean nothing. I have to... Francesco de Pazzi. Help save our city, Auditore. Kill him.
I help save our city. By which you mean help keep me in charge of our city. Well, okay.
Francesco de Pazzi. Brought up as a noble in a city captivated by the newly rich Medici family, Francesco was taught to hate the middle class and its social climbers. Dismayed, he watched as the Medici bank eclipsed his own, and centuries of influence over the Florentine government slipped away. It looks like the Spaniard offered him a solution. Rather than compete in something as dirty as banking, Francesco only had to do one thing for the Templars. One thing to put the middle class in their place for good. Kill the Medici. Giovanni Auditore tried to stop Francesco by putting him in jail. But the Templars took care of that.
Yeah, I'm not sure if about this rising middle class is doing it.
I saw Francesco lead a battalion around the back of the Palazzo della Signoria. I fear he may be seeking another way in.
Go, before it's too late. Do what you can!
Oh, run into the shinies. Valuable shinies too. They're still putting those up in sensible places. Go up high then. Why aren't I dead? Because your men can't fight, that's why. It was obvious. Okay, we'll go the long way around. One down to go. Thank you.
him.
Could have edge killed a few, I suppose, but I feel like the moment for stealth. They're all gone.
It's just us now.
Maledetto che il diavolo ti porti! Stami lontano!
So you could assassins do leaps of faith. Or for Templars, apparently. Ready? Ready? There we go.
Now Firenze will judge you for what you've done.
It's over. It's all over.
I'll spot it.
Meglio essere felici in questa vita e aspirare a esserlo nella prossima. Requiescat in pace.
Whether liberty was really something in the popular conscience like that. By popular conscience, I mean consciousness. Before someone points that out. Also, I thought the assassins were all for freedom and stuff. Still the same year, but apparently sometime later, I guess. Then around the Ponte Vecchio again. Bene.
When I was 6 years old, I fell into the Arno. I soon found myself drifting down and into darkness. Certain my life was at an end. Instead, I walked to the sound of my mother weeping. At her side stood a stranger, soaking and smiling at me. My mother explained that he had saved me. And so began a long and prosperous relationship between two families. Yours and mine. I am sorry I could not save your father and brothers.
You have nothing to apologize for. I believe Jacopo de Pazzi played a part in their deaths. The attack on you as well. I need to find him.
That coward fled before we could arrest him.
Have you any leads?
No. They've hidden themselves well.
They?
Jacopo was not the only conspirator to escape.
If they work with Jacopo, they were surely involved in the plot against my family as well. Give me their names.
Antonio Maffei. Archbishop Francesco Salviati, Stefano da Bagnone, and Bernardo Baroncelli.
Bene. I will go and see my uncle. He has men stationed in the countryside.
Wait. Before you go.
A codex page.
I took it from the files of Francesco de Pazzi, seeing as he clearly no longer needs it. I've always had an interest in things of antiquity. As did your father.
It is meaningful to me as well.
Then consider it a gift. Che il Signore ci protegga.
Ooh, conspirators.
Jacopo de Pazzi. The money. This guy was the head of the Pazzi family, and he ran their banking business. An associate of Lorenzo de' Medici, he had nothing against him personally. So he hired four Templar hitmen to take care of the situation for him. Bernardo di Bandino Baroncelli, brought up to hate the Medici family for the exile of his cousins, Baroncelli ran the numbers in the Pazzi Bank by day and murdered for the Templars at night. It was Baroncelli who delivered the first blow. Stefano de Bagnone. Known for his cruelty, Bagnone was trained in Rome as a Templar butcher. It was Bagnone who stabbed Lorenzo de' Medici in the back. Antonio Maffei. Witness to the sacking of Volterra by Florentine mercenaries, Maffei blamed Lorenzo. He joined the Templars to seek revenge. It was Maffei who slashed Lorenzo's neck. Archbishop Francesco Salviati. Convinced he would be the next Archbishop of Florence, Salviati was enraged when Lorenzo stood in his way. But the Templars were there to heal his wounds. It was Salviati who marched their troops into the city.
A bunch of people's kill. And to look up at some point, see whether they were real. Archbishops, at the very least. Well, you can always convince them, but it was a real Archbishop of Pisa around at the time, I'm sure. Destination contracts unlocked. Okay, very good. Yeah, we'll do that, then we'll go talk to Renzo to see about this. Codex page, and then we will go and do a part villa. And that will be it for today. You will be able to buy a lot of stuff in a villa, that's nice. 20,000 florins. some reason Ezio is now also killing people for hire, which... Doing it for Lorenzo, sure. Makes kind of sense, maybe. Me. Can you imagine Lorenzo requiring the services of an assassin? Does kind of make you question the morality game is going for here. I mean, now an assassin who's murdering people on behalf of a dictator. Pure and simple. Which kind of doesn't quite jive with all. Okay. Doesn't jive with the whole doing it for the good of the people fuel. My fancy cards. That must be worth it to upgrade our weapon 3.
Watch
your step. The guard
lets you to a post and strap you to within an inch of your life. Are you the finest wool, silk, and leather? My craft!
Well, so much for that one. Just endless, I wonder. Try one more. Just open work, open world, busy work.
Raju, get him there. You won't run away this time. Shit. I see him! There!
I'm coming up here to get my son to kill someone for your boss, but hey. Who did I? So I already still couldn't make my way around here without the map.
Will keep
this night. Oops, wrong weapon.
traditional remedies and the wisdom of the Arabi.
No client of mine will ever be caught under threat.
Attenzione! It has come to the attention of the Signoria that your man has been gone.
Named missions, I'm guessing they're not completely random and endless. Also pay nicely. But looking at the time. I'm just gonna go in. Leonardo.
Please don't. I'm sorry. I'll go.
Still the scaffold up, eh? There's still some butchy conspirators to kill. Useful if they put those kind of shortcuts on the map as well.
Come, friends! May wellness remain your companion.
Ezio, thank God you're all right. This madness with the Medici and the Pazzi, is this why you pursued Francesco?
Not exactly.
Well, whatever your reasons, the city's safe again thanks to you. Now tell me, how may I be of service? Ah, another page. Aha, it's a similar cipher to the last one. This won't take long. Interesting. Oh,
indeed. It's a page, but it's kept as a scroll.
It's another blade for delivering poison.
Can you build it?
See, it won't take very long. I just need to find a way to hollow out the blade without sacrificing the...
It's all right, Leonardo. Just do what you need to do.
All done. I filled your blade with a bit of poison to start with. Should you run out, just visit a doctor.
Poison? From a doctor?
In high enough doses, that which cures can kill.
I am in your debt once more, my friend.
Anytime, Ezio. Anytime.
Interesting, in ancient Greek, pharmakoi could mean both poison and... both poison and medicine. New secondary memories unlocked. Huzzah! Tutorial then, okay. Shovel there, that's what I wanted to do anyway.
Price is so low, you won't be.
Welcome to Zibilla. I'm sure. And then it's time to go on a little shopping spree. Oh. Family crypt. Well, look at that then. remember this. Maybe this is DLC or digital deluxe version stuff or something. Paying respects. Chef, to pay respects. Navigating the Atlantic. Is a Venetian sailor? Unlikely. Most likely navigated the Mediterranean. There wasn't much, certainly in Phoenician sailor in about 1300. Why is your blood buddy there? Anyway, that's when he's sailing about 1300. He would, yeah, sail to Turkey, etc., and maybe to Britain, I guess. Or the Baltic. True. Well, I don't know if the Phoenician traders went there. Which was okay. Defended mankind. Don't mark better though. Dante Alighieri. Okay, we made him an assassin. Fair enough. Dante and Marco Polo. Contemporaneous. Oh. I thought Dante was later than Marco Polo. By about a good century, but I could be wrong. Set up to stop us thinking. Mankind has been used by his rulers to be the people who deserve freedom. I'm pretty sure Marco Polo visited with Kublai Khan, not Genghis. Okay. The manuscript, The Codex. Order the assassins, but Codex just means book. So the manuscript, the book. Not so much sense making. entirely unreasonable that that would end up with Genghis Khan, because the real life assassin's orders were put an end to by the Mongol invasion. Well, okay. No, not here. Not all here, it's here. Make that jump, or am I doing something wrong here? Right, that's just what it is. Okay. Let's reset you. Best. Ouch. I wonder if banks really work like that. I need to use a number. Somehow I doubt it. No, come on now, man. Time, which is relatively forgiving. Okay then, maybe not. With the camera kind of not staying behind your character. Made it easier to pay your respects. so bye for never get your name. Camera, which is just an excuse, but only partially so. Come on, Ezio. Obviously, I don't want to run up to the wall there. Just want to come and pay your respects to your ancestors too. Instead of just pressing F. Oh, for crying out. Yes, that is indeed where I wanted you to jump. Well done. See, all of a sudden you are walking 180 degrees the other way, even though you keep holding the same button. Anyway, back either. Did you hear? Wonder when our first. Not that I'm a sequel, just going to be. Come on, it's. Freaking crying out loud. No. Up. Yes. That's it. Well done. going one long fight with the controls, I mean. It's clear what I have to do, it's not a timing challenge. Nobleman, you're one of the people. Yeah. To see risk, which all the noble people were. Especially this period in Italy. No one common person kind of get mixed up. I mean, bankers and all that. Kind of implying that. Lorenzo's one of the people. And really, he's very much not. Someone asked, what assassins have ever done for the people? Just for some story background and money? I guess so. Just for some story background. After a couple of centuries of being a noble family. You're a noble family. No, just there isn't an orphanage or free hospital in Montelegione. So, you know. That's what this was. So, I'd definitely be doing a better job of looking after the people. That's my beef in general with this, right? Altair killed a bunch of people because he was told to. The guise of that cause and peace. Just pretty. Some pretext to see through. Ezio was just killing people because they murdered his father. And I'm supposed to believe that the assassins are all noble and do this for the good cause and defending humanity and stuff.
Come, don't be shy.
It's just, you know, not really matching up with each other. So. Ooh, kinds of interesting symbols going on. Bunnies. Upgrade.
Salute, Claudia.
You here to look at the book?
Hang on. So she's looking at the book. Right.
A presto, Ezio.
Not sure I could just put that in the menu. Told her I have to give Claudia something to do.
Salute, Ser Ezio. Shall we take a look at the list?
Game continues on with not giving the architect a name, right? Only named people matter. Only guards don't matter. So, do you want to renovate the church? And I want to fix the well. And now to get thief skills. And I think the city needs a tailor. And art merchants. And expensive. Lands. Central purchases, yes please. Okay, can't afford the next level yet. Afford a better bank, more income, yes please. Okay, and we save the rest of the money.
Buon viaggio.
Supplies. Great journey value, what's more? She's just the architect, so he doesn't matter, just like all guards don't matter.
Salute, Claudia.
Count his innocence. Slaughter them at will. There we go, 5,000 florins per 20 minutes. Bank is. And actually, fairly fast, bank is bringing itself back very quickly. Renovations, lots of value. 4% complete. Needle arms, etc.
A presto, Ezio.
Mario lost. Just the feathers. To our hideaway. Pushing 100. Yeah, no way I'm gonna get up to 100. Still creepy. Just gonna Patsy. Wonder what his real life fate was. The fate that secret powers put in the history books. You know, I do have to wonder. But that's what Vidic was saying. First game, you know, he says that the Templars have delivered all kinds of inventions for the good of mankind. They've also, of course, also, of course, once you subjugate mankind and mind control them, well, that's bad. Also, apparently, given us all these nice inventions and stuff, it does make you wonder what have the assassins ever done for mankind? Apart from murder some people, which may or may not have done something useful. That was an idea. We'll have a little think about that in a sec, or in a second, a couple of minutes when we visit our fancy vault. You know what? There's 2 boxes of money. Get that. see what the shops have on offer. Think about it, should have upgraded the doctor. Some thieves killed himself with flags. Shmanshi Bank.
I'm sure I have just what you need.
We're all, yes. Can't pay for certainly can't pay for all those. So we won't buy these.
Should do, I hope, and please come back often.
Come, let my experience garnish you with the finest style available.
Come, friend.
Do you require a medical? That should heal quickly now.
I have an astonishing collection at the moment. And for this week only, I offer items.
Expensive.
Next time, then.
When you buy a drifting core out there, please.
Cheap. What can I buy here? Expensive for now.
Grazie, and come again.
Right over there, earn some more money first.
A great metal work here.
That's strange on the map. Oh look, flags. Nice. Some of the map is no longer board up, some of the map must mean that I can hand in my stuff. Very nice.
Come in, come in! To what do we owe the honor?
Right, let's look at the Coke's page. Coke's page. Let's write these down. Some points. Do that now. Then we can see which ones are new. And there's Jacobo de Pazzi's co-conspirators. So, let's place some seals. Do you have this one? No.
This one. There it is. And Danny. Okay, so these are not just famous assassins because they managed to assassinate someone famous, but also because they defended mankind during its greatest hour of need. Blah blah. So let's have a look at who these people were. So, someone shot Genghis Khan's horse, not another Genghis Khan. Yeah, how did that save mankind? Guess if the Mongol invasion had come further, maybe we would have all been subjugated to the Mongols. Maybe the Mongol invasion was secret Templar plots. Okay, whether. And the Mongol invasions of Europe at one point did stop because of the death of a Khan and everybody had to go back. So, okay, maybe I can buy assassinating a Khan would help that. But then. Darius used the Hidden Blade to kill Xerxes. Doesn't mention which Xerxes, I think there were more, but it's the Persian king. Who I think was relatively autocratic, but no more or lesser than other rulers of that era, and he was succeeded by someone who had the same style of rule. So, not quite sure how that was defending humanity. He'd lost the war against Greeks anyway. That was the angle they were going for. No, he didn't die during that. So. Killed the first Chinese emperor. Yeah, I think on the whole, being unified and culturally stable and whatnot was good for China. But you're working the first emperor was a good thing. Yeah, killed Cleopatra with the snake. That is utter nonsense. I mean, okay, even if we buy that Cleopatra was assassinated rather than commit suicide, there was basically a civil war between Mark Antony and Cleopatra, and Octavian, who went on to become Emperor Augustus. Yeah, potato potato, whoever won that. I mean, Octavian slash Augustus was hardly a champion of freedom and democracy. In fact, he put an end to the Roman Republic. Although, of course, Mark Antony won. He hardly would have, probably would have done more or less the same thing. So, you killed a defeated ruler who was no worse than the person, or better than the person who won. Yay. Poisoned Alexander the Great. Okay, he may have gone on to world subjugation if and died, unlikely, but in the context of the game, sure. Though, yeah, I don't know if it made mankind worse that they were his empire splintered. But, okay, you can say maybe, you know, one unified world government is bad, so killing Alexander putting into that, you can see that one. And stabbed Caligula. Yeah, okay, Caligula was bad, but he didn't really create freedom and democracy, you just got a slightly less bad emperor to follow him up. No. Just killing a single person is not really the answer, you have to have some entire regime change plan in place. For a recent example, see Iraq.
Ezio! Come in, come in! To what do we owe the honor?
Oops. So, I want to change. Go. Ah! Rejection, not Mercator. talk with him, and then it is time to end the stream.
I've been sent from Firenze by El Magnifico to attend to some unfinished business. I'm looking for Jacopo de Pazzi.
Ha! Who isn't? We've been at it for days.
And perhaps what I carry will help us both. A list of his co-conspirators. One of them will talk before he dies.
Excellent. These men are sure to lack Jacopo's resources, which means they will be easier to find. I will put my scouts to it at once.
I appreciate the help, Uncle. I've got something else for you as well. More codex pages.
Ah, let's see what we can learn. What is this? What profit?
What did you find, Uncle?
Just another damn mystery. The text here roughly translates to only the prophet may open it. There's reference to two pieces of Eden, but these pages offer no answers, Nipote. At least, not on their own. You must find more.
We'll have to save it for another day, Uncle. I have a mission to attend to.
As you wish. Now, if you hope to defeat these bastardi, I will need to teach you a few things. Meet me on the practice field.
Sure.
All right, Ezio. You're familiar with counterattacking, but what happens when your enemy is as well?
I don't usually give them the opportunity.
Tough talk offers little protection against Templar steel.
Then by all means, Maestro, teach me what to do.
Now dodge.
Bene, bene. Now do it again. Much better. One last time now.
Bravo.
Let's see it another time. Just one more time.
Magnifico! Once again, you exceed my expectations.
Signore, we found Jacopo's men, and they wait your word to strike.
Relay the following. No man moves until they have spoken with Ezio. Intesi?
It will be done.
Go, Ezio. Visit with my mercenaries in the countryside. See if Jacopo's lackeys won't lead you to him. But be careful. They will be expecting you.
Hello, monies. Some more paintings. Lady with a nearby. Leonardo da Vinci again. Shopping, and then I'm gonna watch a stream. Now we have a full chat. What's up?
offense, but I didn't think you had the money.
Right. Well, that was it. Thank you for watching and see you next time.